Performing physical tasks such as lifting, part assembly, and even walking can lead to worker fatigue. When designing jobs on the plant floor, it's important to factor in time for recovery. This recovery can play a critical role in avoiding injury and maintaining quality standards for manual assembly tasks. For version 10.1 of Process Simulate Human, we have introduced a real-time fatigue tool. This new ergonomic analysis tool looks at individual body areas, such as the wrists, shoulders, and back, and provides feedback about how much recovery time is recommended to make the task acceptable from a fatigue perspective. In this example, a worker is required to stock her workstation, carrying parts in large boxes from a nearby container to her work area. You will notice that the box weights vary from 5 to 12 kilograms. Also new for Process Simulate Human version 10.1, objects can be highlighted to emphasize when the human is grasping them. Here, you'll see that they are highlighted in magenta. After moving the boxes to the table, the worker has to complete her assembly task, which is repeated several times throughout the day. A simulation of the job demands was created so that the task could be analyzed from a fatigue perspective. From the fatigue report, we can see that there is excessive strain or fatigue on the left shoulder, which occurs between 16 and 21 seconds of the simulated task. During this time, the worker is lifting the lowest box from her parts bin and carrying it to the workstation area. Because the worker must immediately resume her assembly task, there is not enough time for adequate recovery. As a potential solution, we tested the impact of having parts presented closer to the workstation to minimize the time the worker was required to handle the parts. We also modified the box weight so that the heaviest box was not presented lowest to the ground. We re-ran the fatigue analysis to look at the impact of these changes. From the report, you can see that we not only eliminated the fatigue accumulation at the shoulder, but these changes also had a significant impact on the time required to stock parts. Originally, it took the worker approximately 26 seconds to move all of the boxes, whereas now it can be done in under 10 seconds. Using Process Simulate, we were also able to review the impact of installing a conveyor system in the facility so that parts could be picked in the warehouse and auto-delivered to each workstation via the conveyors. This approach could entirely eliminate the need for manual material handling at the assembly workstation.